All right, people, listen up. This is the CEAP, the Community Energy Action Plan, a 5-year plan chock full of actions the city and community are taking to make London greener, more livable, and just a swell place to live in general. We're halfway through the plan, and there's stuff to celebrate. But first, let's play a bit of catch-up. Now, you're probably asking yourself, why do we even have the CEAP? The first big reason is money. Ooh, money's great. Gets us nice things like food, furniture, and fine art, the 3 F's. Well, put down the paintbrush there, Picasso, because it turns out we spend $1.4 billion every year on energy. Worst part is, 90% of that chunk of change zips out of our community faster than you can say anthropogenic carbon dioxide molecules. Our energy use also produces GHGs, a handy little acronym for greenhouse gases. Now, most Canadians agree that we don't really want to live in a giant greenhouse of the apocalypse with thunderstorms, flooding, and winds of biblical proportion, which is why the City of London, plus the province and the feds, have set targets for reducing those pesky GHGs. And the good news is, the City of London's on track to meet or exceed those targets. Congratulations. But don't break out the non-alcoholic sparkling grape juice and party favors just yet. We still have a lot of work to do to make sure we all keep them GHGs down. So, if you're thinking we gotta clean up the whole country by ourselves, relax. With the CEAP, London joins more than 200 communities, over half of the Canadian population, each with a customized plan for reducing impacts and saving some moolah. So, how do we keep cash in our pockets and also keep Mother Nature happy? We need to think local first. Now, City Hall's not telling you what to do because, well, frankly, they don't live in your house or drive your car. You do. So, we talked to loads of Londoners, and turns out you and your neighbors know what your community needs. If you work together, everything you do adds up PDQ, which means pretty darn fast. Now you might say, well, hey, man, let's just make energy cheaper. Sorry, pal, can't do that. But if you make some different choices in the way you live and get around ski, you can reduce your own energy costs by a whole lot. More on that in a bit. Back to the CEAP. This is the part where we celebrate. Across the board, emissions are down since 1990, especially in our houses, where we are down 45%. That's so close to half it hurts just a little bit, and I'm not saying where. We're also way ahead of where we plan to be with renewable power. It adds up quick. $400 million in avoided costs since 2010. That's a lot of moolah. Now you're probably asking yourself, what are avoided costs and how do they happen? Well, avoided costs add up fast when we invest in energy efficiency improvements. In fact, anything we do that uses less energy means we spend less money than if we had sat back and done diddly squat, done nothing, rested on our laurels, things of that nature. But put those party hats away for a minute, because we've still got some work to do. Turns out, vehicles use up the most energy by far, and our use of gasoline keeps going up. Why, you ask? Oh, so glad you did. Here's how much our adult population has grown since 2011. And here's the growth in car population. Who the heck is driving these cars? And while we're doing pretty well in our houses, burning gasoline in cars when we're not at home now accounts for over half of the average household's emissions. Plus, while these cars generate 35% of all of London's emissions, that's over 2 times more than all of London's industry, including planes and trains and all the big stuff. So, it's on all of us, not just the big guys. Now, no one is saying to get rid of cars, it's just that we gotta use them less, and when we do, use them wisely. Hey now, keep those party hats and party pants on, people, because there's more good news. In the last 5 years, the number of hybrid and electric vehicles has nearly tripled. They still make up less than 1% of cars on the road, but that just means we'll keep tooting our party favors every time that number gets bigger. Toot, toot. There's plenty of other things we can all do. When you're getting around, try riding the bus, grabbing a ride from a friend, biking or walking or even skipping. Plus, try swapping out that classic incandescent lamp for LEDs. And next time you're buying an appliance, look for this handy logo. Try drying your clothes on a line. According to the young people, vintage is totally hip. Plus, now you can get a fancy app to show your friends and neighbors how much you've saved. Or you can share your stories and track your energy use at citygreenstories.ca. Together, we can make London, Ontario an even better place to live. And if you ask me, that's PDG. Pretty darn awesome.